Hi, my name is Dr. Michael Sebatis. I'm a consultant in the Performance Office at the Connecticut State Department of Education. This is one in a series of recorded sessions on using the CSDE's data reporting portal, EdSight, to support Connecticut's English learner, multilingual learner student population. This population are English learners in that they're working to develop their level of English language proficiency, but they're also multilingual in that they have a level of proficiency in more than one language. At the end of school year 22-23, there were more than 50,000 LML students in Connecticut public schools. Together, they account for more than 10% of all Connecticut public school students. This session is about the Lost Links Achievement Mastery Report that's located in EdSight Secure. Under federal educational law, all English learners, grades K to 12, are required to take an annual English language proficiency assessment that includes the four language domains of speaking and listening, reading and writing. In Connecticut, that ELP assessment is the Lost Links. It's an online assessment that is generally administered the beginning of January through the beginning of March. This report includes scale score and performance level information for the Lost Links for its four subtests of listening, speaking, reading, and writing, along with five additional composite scores. And the composites are various combinations of the four subtests, and they highlight particular skill areas. The report also provides information about English language mastery attainment. And this is whether students have met the CSDE's exit standard, which indicates that a student is proficient, that is, that they have a level of English language proficiency that they can access mainstream curriculum without language supports. In Connecticut, the English Mastery Standard is overall proficiency along with reading and writing proficiency from the Lost Links assessment. Students who meet the Mastery Standard in a particular school year finish out the school year as an English learner. And then in the following school year, they are no longer reported as an LML, and they no longer have to take the Lost Links assessment. Results in this report date from school year 2015-16. Now, just to be clear, EdSight, the data reporting portal, consists of two parts. There's public EdSight, which is located on the CSDE's webpage, and that's a collection of aggregate student and district reports. EdSight Secure is a restricted data reporting portal, and while it includes aggregate information, it also includes student-level information. Districts have been given accounts, which they alone manage, to access the information in EdSight Secure, and they see information only for their currently registered students. Or students, in some cases in the assessment, who were registered with them at the time they took a particular assessment. So, in turning to the report, the Lost Links Achievement Report, we're going to start with the main report that's available. And we see this graph. This is the percent, this is by performance level and on the Lost Links assessment for the four subtests and the five composites, there are five performance levels ranging from beginner, early intermediate, intermediate, proficient, and above proficient. The great thing about graphs in EdSight Secure You get to see the numbers, first of all, the aggregate numbers for each of the groups. But you can drill down right to the students who are behind the numbers. So just by double clicking a section of any graph in EdSight Secure, you get all of the students who are included in that group. Now, if you want that information, you can print out this list of who those students are, or you can export this data. And by exporting, what we mean is a process whereby the student level information is transferred to your computer, in particular your download folder. Now, when you say you want to export, when you click the export option, you see all these different fields of information that are available in the report that could be included in the download. Now, if for some reason you're not interested or you don't want a particular piece of information, you can unclick that field and it won't be included. By clicking the field, it will be included. And when you're ready, when you have the fields that you're interested in, you just click OK. And then that Excel workbook with that information will be downloaded to your computer. And similarly, with any graph that you find in EdSight Secure, you can either print it, you can save the image, or you can export it to your computer. So the really great thing about EdSight Secure is while it presents aggregate results, you're able to drill down to the student level to see who are the kids behind the numbers. So there's a number of filters that are provided in looking at this report. So right here is one of the most important decisions that you need to make, because it's two different views of the information. If you click Tested District, what you get to see is the results for the students who tested with you. So they were with you at the time they took the assessment. And I think in general that Tested District is particularly appropriate when you're trying to answer the question, how are we doing? When you're assessing your results as a district or school, because these are the kids that you tested and you probably had for some amount of time. The other view of the data is current district. So these are results for students who are currently registered with you. Whether they took the Lost Links with you or not, they're currently registered with you, they're included in this tab. And I think the information here is particularly appropriate when you're doing programmatic planning, because you're planning for the students that you currently have. There's also this set of filters that are located in the middle of the page. And what they're doing is they're giving you a subset of students, the results for a subset of students. So you can filter for a particular year. And in fact, let me take a step back. To see what you're filtering, this is very handy. So this tells you what information that you're looking at. So this graph, we know, is for the district. It's the overall composite score, and it's for school year 22-23. You can filter by school. Let's click that off. You can pick any of the four subtests or five composite scores. Let's look at reading. You can pick any combination of grades. So let's say we're interested in reading in middle school. You can pick demographic options like gender, race, ethnicity, whether a student is a special education student. And this student learning model, this really just refers to school year 2021. Only the results for that year, the COVID year, when some students were learning remotely, others were only in person, and some were receiving a mix of the two. So these, again, these filters are just giving you that subset. That's all you're looking at. So for example, I'm just looking at the district level for reading for the middle school grades, and that's what I'm getting. But say what I was interested in was doing a comparison. Well, the filters on the side will allow you to do that. So let's turn off some of these filters that we selected. And let's say we want to do a comparison for the last 2 years of two different schools. So we've selected schools A and C, and we've selected 21-22 and 22-23. And what we're going to do is we want to make a comparison by school of the results. So here we're comparing school A and school C, and we want to see their results also by school year. So now we can make these comparisons across these two school years for the results. But let's say we want to make it a more apples to apples comparison, and we're really just kind of interested in comparing these schools, sixth graders. So here's our results. So there are so many possibilities in how you combine these two sets of filters. And again, it's really just kind of limited by your imagination. And also the question that you're trying to answer. A lot of times it's good to start out with, what is my question? What is it I'm trying to see in the data? So again, these are for current district, but if I was really interested in making a comparison by, and I wanted to sort of assess these two schools and how they did with the students they may have had for a while, I'd select tested district and then look at this comparison. So let me get rid of these filters. And let's look at another tab of information that's available in the LostLinks Achievement Report. Mastery Report. And again, these are the students who are meeting the English Mastery Standard, and they'll be exiting LML status in the following school year. And so again, we have this set of filters where we can look at it for a particular school. We can say okay, no results for say school A. So here's school A's results. We can see for the last 2 years for school A, their mastery results. And just like any graph in EdSight, we can click and see results. So these are the students who met mastery in school year 22-23. And again, we can print off that list. We can export that list. Another tab of information that's available in the Lost Links report, Lost Links Achievement Report, is trend data. And what we're looking at here is the vertical scale scores over time. So again, we can pick our particular years, but there's no harm in selecting all of the years available. You can choose a particular school. So here we're looking at school A. And you can pick, we've already picked writing. So we're looking at writing vertical scale scores over these, over this period of years. And in particular, we're looking here at the middle school students and seeing for grades 6, 7, and 8, what does writing look like over this period of time? And we can also, we can filter for gender, we can filter for race, ethnicity, we could look for special education status. We could say, okay, we're only interested in looking at those students who were not identified for special education and see the results. And like any graph, again, you could save the image, you can export it, you can print it. Student level data. And again, this is the advantage of EdSight Secure compared to public EdSight, is that you can find results at the student level. So first of all, if you were interested in searching for the results for, say, just one particular student, you could search for that student by SACID. And the SACID is a 10-digit unique state-issued identifier that every student, every public school student has. If you don't know the SACID, you could search by their last name to try and find their results. And if you're searching for a student's results, I'd suggest click all of the years, because this is a very mobile student population. A student, if you've selected only the current year, you may miss that they did not test, or the most recent year, I should say. They might not have tested in the most recent school year, but they may have tested 2 years back, 3 years back. So it's good to click all of these years when you're looking for the information for a particular student. And again, you have the choice of taking particular schools and programs. You can say, I just am interested in one particular subtest. I want just the results. And again, this might be, let's say you're thinking about programmatic planning. So you say current district. And I'm interested in the results from 22-23 for writing. And I'm interested in high school students. And you'd also, if you're coming up and you're creating a roster, you want to click the kids who did not achieve mastery in 22-23. So that means that they're still an LML student. If you want to throw in different demographic filters, you can. But the great thing is this allows you to roster, to create different rosters for yourself at the district level or at school level, school and grade level, for your staff who may be responsible for particular subsets of students. And to be able to say, here are your students here when it comes to writing, here's how they did in the most recent assessment. And again, just like any graph or list in EdSight Secure, you can print, save the image, or export the data. So now you have this list of kids. Maybe you're interested in saying, okay, I want to know for this group of students, who are the students who were at level one, just beginning in writing, because maybe we want to create a program to meet their needs. Well, there's your list of high school students right there. And you can download that list, and you and your staff can review that list of kids or know who you're doing a particular outreach for. And a little trick, a nice little trick with any table in EdSight Secure, you can rearrange these columns in whatever order you prefer. So let's say what you would like is you want school name to be up front. So you click on that column and the heading and drag it over to where you want it. Grade. Click and drag. So you can rearrange all of these. And for many of the columns, you're able to sort in either ascending or descending order. So there's a lot of functionality in this report to allow the data that you are going to download or print to be in the format and in the order that you want. Another thing, another important tab is the resources tab. So you've got general documentation about using EdSight Secure, and then you have resources that are related to the English learner, multilingual learner population. So that's the Lost Links Achievement Report. Let's close that out. And I also want to draw your attention to something in EdSight Secure. There's the EdSight Secure Resources Library, where there's more information available, more videos and documentation about using EdSight or particular reports. There's also the link when you need help to contact the EdSight team. And I would say they are extremely responsive and very helpful. So if you have a question, you should reach out to them. There's also a link on accessibility and using EdSight Secure. And then there's this link also to EdSight Public. And what I would suggest is that when you're looking at your own individual district results, a comparison with EdSight Public is often useful because there is a Lost Links Achievement Report and Mastery Report in EdSight Public, as there is also for Lost Links Growth. And in these reports, they provide state level, district and school level information. So what this allows you to do is to take your own district results and put them in a larger context, comparing with the state or perhaps a district that's similar to you in terms of the size of their LML population and or socioeconomic demographic factors, so that you can sort of place your numbers in a context. So for example, you might see that 17% of your students typically are reaching mastery. Well, how does that compare to the state? We can just take a quick look. Here's Lost Links in the public. Take mastery. And we see that if your district is typically seeing that 17% of its students are meeting mastery, that's above the state level. So using EdSight Secure in combination with EdSight Public often is very helpful in deepening the understanding of your particular group of students. Thank you for your attention, and please feel free and to use EdSight Secure.